Alright folks, we got Snapshot 21w41a with a new world generation random source and a new surface system for custom worlds. If you want the gameplay features, check out my update video right here. In this video, we're going to go through all the technical changes in the snapshot. My name is slicedlime, let's dive right in. Almost all of it is focused on custom worlds this time around, but let's start with one other change concerning the server jar. Maybe this is interesting if you deal with servers or modding. The server jar file is now signed and can be verified offline without the need for a separate manifest hash. And that leaves only custom world changes, so let's get into it. The vanilla data features dark forest vegetation red and dark forest vegetation brown have been merged, only a dark forest vegetation remains. Another note is that in the overworld biome, legacy random source is now set to false. As for format updates, there is a new feature stage that has been added to all biomes, specifically being used for water and lava springs that are now being done earlier than before. The surface builder concept has been removed, so the entire worldgen/configured surface builder folder is now gone, and the surface builder field in biomes is also gone. Instead, noise settings now have a surface rule field, which is a combination of rules to decide which surface block gets chosen. There are four available rules, and these together can be used to create a huge decision tree. The simplest rule is block, which simply sets the surface to be a given block state specified by the result state field. There's also sequence, which has a single field, also called sequence, which is a list of other rules. These rules will run one by one until one successfully returns a state. Then there's a condition rule, which checks a condition in the if true field, and if that condition evaluates to true, runs another rule in the then run field. Otherwise, it fails. And let me stall for just one more moment before we get into the conditions and ask you to please activate the like button, since that helps the video reach more people on YouTube. Thank you. Now for conditions, there are a number of these that can be used to check many different things. Biome checks if the surface generation is happening in a biome that is in the biome is field, which is a list of biome IDs. Noise threshold checks if the value of a noise from the noise field is between min threshold and max threshold at the surface generation point. Y above checks that the generated surface is at a point above a vertical anchor specified by the anchor field. It also has run depth multiplier and add stone depth fields. A similar condition is the water condition, which checks for water at an offset, also with run depth multiplier and add stone depth fields. A third similar condition is stone depth, which checks for hitting the depth of stone at a surface given as either floor or ceiling in the surface type field. It also has an add run depth field. In addition to this, there's a not condition for inverting the result of another condition. That condition is specified in the invert field. And finally, there are a number of special conditions without any fields at all. They are temperature, steep, and hole. All of those combine to create a huge decision tree for the overworld, and a somewhat less complicated one for the end. And that's it for the technical changes in 21w41a. Thank you to everyone still watching all the way to the end, I do appreciate it. And if you like this, maybe you'll also like another one of my videos here. Check it out! What is the most efficient mode of transport known to Minecraft? Well, it's teleportation, of course. So today we're going to build a server-wide teleporter